for you. I just explained a little bit my pathway. It's very simple. I got my certificate in science, and then I started coaching in the tennis club. And I decided to pick a year off to travel and blah, 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 do the whole thing and see what was going on in tennis around the world. And I ended up to be in Florida. So I spent 2 months at the Palmer Academy, and they offered me the job there. So I took it. I said, well, I don't know, that was cool to be able to answer. I said, okay, I'll stay. And that's how I started to coach professional players. So I started with the million two, the American player. And I don't know, these 2 years. And I just give you the few names because I'm doing this now since 16 years. And I'm on the tour since then. And I just do privately, basically. I did with Melin Tube, then I did with Anne Kramer, Gisela Dutko, Elena Kotseva, Zvonareva, and then now Victoria Azarenka. So in 16 years, that's like, I don't know, there's not that many players when you do that. Pretty much every week things are changing on the tour, so I'm kind of lucky. That's basically my experience on a professional tour. As you can see, there's not that many guys because I got lucky. Otherwise, Ruben asked me to work with them, so I just stay on the women's tour. So that's also pretty interesting. I'm here to talk, I think, about my experience with Victoria Azarenka a little bit and what we do on the tour and what basically took both of us, you know, at the top of the pyramid. So. I can talk about it all day long if you want, but we thought that maybe if we do a question answer things, that's a little bit more interactive, you know, and if you have any questions about all this, because I don't know about you, but I made quite a lot of mistakes with all those players that I work with, and then I try to learn from it, and then we always try to move forward, okay? Because the bottom line is always to try to be the best as we can. So not only the player that works also for the coach, so I'm trying to be the best coach as I can possibly can, but obviously the player helps me a lot. But along the way, I guarantee you I made a lot of mistakes. I still make a lot every day, but well, I'm still learning, I guess. So if you have any questions regarding my work with Victoria or the previous experiences that I got or what we do at the top level, I'm
Can I ask the first question? When you started, how long ago did you start? How long time have you worked with Azarenka?
I started in January 2010, so I just started my fourth year.
What was the first thing that you started to work on? You know the relationship. You know what was the first thing?
First thing is that I don't know, because there is so many things that I wanted to do right away, and it's not possible to take care about everything right away. So I thought that the main thing was I had a kind of in my head the vision where and how I wanted her to play, because she was playing completely different at that time. It was very good, don't get me wrong. She was already top 10 when I started with her, so she was an excellent player. But I always remember Victoria when I was working with Vera Zvonareva. And when I was working with Zvonareva, they play against each other, obviously. And for me, it was always when we were setting up the strategy with Zvonareva to play against Azarenka, that was kind of easy to go play Azarenka and beat her, seriously. So I thought that was. So, and I knew why, obviously. I never told Victoria this, but I kind of knew it. So because of that, I thought that maybe if we were doing other stuff, she would be more difficult to beat, these type of things, so to make her a more complete player. But in order to do all this, my problem was to, at the beginning, and I think it took me like 6 or 8 months to understand the player. And that was my main job at the beginning. It's try to understand the athlete, because it's different personality than the previous one that I coach. And I think we all know how to teach a forehand and a backhand and all of these. That's not the most difficult part. You know, you just take the basket and only for 10 hours and you're going to make it better. But the problem was to understand a little bit how she's working, how she functions a little bit. And in order to know that, that I knew that would help me to get where I mean, my vision for her was, and that was my first work. But that was tough because I didn't understand anything about. And then I started to figure out. She adapted a lot quicker to me because she was coming out of 4 years with the same coach before me. She adapted a lot quicker to me than me I did to her. So that was my first big issue.
But you know that some, you know, she had some, you know, when we've seen her back, you know, on the court, she seems a little bit crazy, you know, she was angry and stuff
they're
like
all
that.
Crazy.
They're all crazy. But you know, how did you work specifically on her between points and stuff like that quite early, because it was a big change at some point?
Well, we didn't work it that way. I'm serious when I say they're all crazy, but I mean it in a good way, okay? Because they're all characters, okay? And I think that's what makes them so good, is because they are characters. And they have that attitude and all this and blah, blah, blah. But that's why they're, in a way, special, I think. So if you work with a strong character, I think it's a good sign. It's actually a good thing to have. Now it's not easy to handle because the strong characters, they look like, I don't know, they want to look strong, but in fact they're probably a lot more sensitive and emotional than anybody else. So that's what you have to deal with. So in order for her to understand all this, she just needed to learn a lot about herself. And that's the work we tried to do. And we got some, a lot of talking, a lot of this, but she really wanted to improve that aspect of her personality, but that's also an aspect of her game, okay? So we kind of like did the same way as a forehand and a backhand or the whole game. We kind of like took a piece of paper and we started thinking, okay, where do we start, you know? Go from point A to point B. So we took it, it's part of the training, basically, if I can say it like this. It's part of that, but it helps her also off the court. It's not just on the court, it helps her in her life, I guess. So that's more than just, I don't know. But this is the beauty of, the professional players. It's more than just the mind stroke or serve or whatever, or fitness. It's just you take the whole personality.